guys, welcome back to my channel. So Doug's gonna cook that, and last time he made the most bomb potatoes ever. So I'll link the recipe that he based it off of.
So in mine is...
Well, teach them how to make
it. Okay, so what you do is you boil the potatoes until they're pretty much done.
Yeah.
And then what you do is you kind of mix them in a pot real quick, or like in a bowl, like this. And that gets them all kind of like mushy, kind of.
Yeah.
But not totally mushy.
Uh-huh.
And you put them on a foil pan, and usually you would use some kind of oil to cover these with, but since we're out of olive oil...
He uses butter because we're out of olive oil, which...
Yeah.
It, I mean, it's gonna taste better with butter anyways, let's be honest.
So, but then for the seasoning, what I use is I do chopped garlic.
Yeah.
Rosemary, basil, and red peppers.
Yeah, and he like puts that on there. So it's
after,
so good.
So then after you boil them and then you season them and mix them a little bit, then you bake them at 400 degrees.
Oh.
Until they're nice and brown.
Look at that glorious steak.
I think it's gonna be really good.
So this is the dinner Doug made. We've got filet mignon and top sirloin and those potatoes I was telling you guys about. They are so good and the edges are perfectly crisp.
Right now we're gonna make chocolate chip cookies, and I haven't made these in a while because normally I make my like peanut butter oatmeal chocolate chip cookie like combo, which if you haven't made that recipe, you guys seriously should, because all of the people that have made my recipe have said they're the best cookies they ever made. But this time I thought I would make just regular chocolate chip cookies because I know some people don't like peanut butter and some people don't like oatmeal. So I've been making these for a while, and these are my next best recipe, although that one is my favorite because I like all three of the ingredients combined. But these are just regular ones. So if you want to check out the blog post for these cookies, I will link it below. I really wanted to make these cookies because I ordered some new, I guess like bakeware from Amazon, and they are from a brand called X Chef. So I will leave the link to everything I'm mentioning below, but I thought I would show you guys what I got.
So the first thing I got are these tea infusers, and you get a ton of them, so that is really nice. So yeah, you basically just put your loose leaf tea in here and then drop this into your mug, and yeah, you have like perfect tea. I've used this before and Doug's about to use it right now, but this works amazingly. I have a bunch of loose leaf like milk inducing teas for breastfeeding, and I never had a tea infuser, so I got a bunch of these and I'm really excited to try them out. I also got these silicone cooking gloves, which are amazing because they fit Doug's hand because they're huge. Usually they're way too small, but these will fit anybody. And I wanted to get these because I always feel like oven mitts just don't do the job, especially when you're handling a cast iron pan and also a Dutch oven. They're just kind of sketchy, so I got these because they obviously have fingers on them. So they work up to 200 degrees Fahrenheit, so that is really nice. And I like that they're silicone, so you can just throw them in the dishwasher. Not that we have one, but you can rinse them in just like your sink and wash them that way as well. So the last thing I got from X Chef was this nonstick oven liner, and these are amazing for baking or just like cooking in general. I haven't used these yet. This is my first time using them, so this will kind of be like a review, but so far they stick really well. They have a non-slit bottom, so you can put these and use them instead of parchment paper for if you're baking cookies, so you don't have to hassle with washing your baking sheet. They're also BPA free, and you can use them if you want to, like, I don't know, have your cookies cool and you don't want them to obviously touch your counter, or if you want to use them as like a cutting board or something like that. Okay, so this recipe makes more cookies than we need to eat, so I'm gonna probably freeze this, but this is what the bake sheets look like. Looks pretty good. And this one I just put a few on just to fill it up, and now I'm going to bake it in the oven. So that's what the tea steeper looks like. You can't really tell, but Doug kind of oversteeped his tea.
I did oversteep it.
Did it work? Did you like it?
Yeah, it actually works really well, and it's an easy way to do loose leaf rather than trying to come up with something or buying like
an expensive thing.
Bags.
Yeah.
Okay, the cookies out.
So this is what the cookies look like. This little pad is amazing. The cookies came right off, and yeah, so I'll definitely link below everything that I mentioned that I got from X Chef, and also the blog post of these cookies. How yummy do they look?
But if you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button and make sure to like this video if you liked it, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.